In this video, I'm going to give you a short example of what I think the tangent normal brush engine can be used for. I think this is a useful tool in production for normal map retouching for the most part, or if you are not an experienced 3D artist or want to use normal maps for 2D games. I will first expose the cases in which I think this tool can be useful in production, and then I will show you a few techniques I found experimenting with the brush engine. We are used to generating normal maps from high-resolution 3D meshes or sculpts, or even using height maps, but the way Krita does it, we are not so used to working that way. It's part of the Krita toolset, so if you know how to work with brushes in Krita, you basically kind of know how to work with the tangent normal brush engine as well. It works really well if you are going to paint painterly textures, you know, Blizzard style, in Krita directly. Then you can use the same toolset to make your normal maps on top of it without having to jump into a 3D software and sculpt everything, which takes a lot of time. I think that the tangent normal brush engine is good in two cases. For one, it's good for retouching, for normal map post-production in a sense. Let's imagine you baked your normals, or you get some normal map from the internet, or you generate it with whatever tools, and there are some artifacts, there are some planes you want to flatten on your normal map. With this tool, it's very easy. You just select a portion of your normal map, you brush in, and you're done. It is generally pretty hard to manipulate a normal map without a dedicated software. Well, in Krita, you can do some operations. You can add curvature to your resulting normal map, or you can flatten parts of it. Maybe you are a 2D game artist and you are working on a 2D game in pixel art or with a regular cel-shaded or painterly style. Well, you can use this tool to assist you in the creation of normal maps if you want to add dynamic lighting to your 2D sprites. In this case, it is not necessary to go through the whole 3D workflow and pipeline. You have a lot of tools to learn if you are going to dive into 3D. There is modeling, UV, sculpting, how to work with textures, and you also have to learn about the rendering settings for baking. So, I think in this case, using this tool in Krita along with a normal map generator can be very useful. I couldn't find a normal map generator that's free, open source, and that runs on every platform. So in that case, the only options I know about are paid software. There's Shader Map on one end, and there would be Bitmap to Material, maybe because it's part of the Substance suite from Algorithmic. Let us now talk about concrete techniques you can use to take the most out of this tool. First of all, you can use a soft brush tip to add curvature to your existing normal map data. You just have to pick the basic tangent normal brush to lower its fade value to make it a bit more blurry. Then you can insert a new layer. You can change its blending mode to normal map, which you can find in the miscellaneous blending mode category. And whatever you are going to paint with the tangent normal brush is going to be added to the underlying normal map. It's going to tweak its vector data, but it's going to preserve the details. That way, you can alter the overall orientation of a certain area of your normal map. The second technique is using selections for edge control. Edge control is the same problem here as it is with regular painting. If you just play with the brush and the eraser, it's hard to get crisp edges. So you can use the lasso selection tool and then paint within your selections. The last technique consists of flattening surfaces, painting flat planes from your diffuse texture. Wolfra allowed me to use her art to give you this demo. So using that, I made a different diffuse texture with more flat planes compared to the original. I'm using that to create my normal map. I just select parts of the diffuse texture using the contiguous and color selection tools. And on another layer, I just paint the planes with my tangent normal brush. That is both useful to create a normal map from your diffuse texture, which you have painted in Krita, for instance, but it is also very useful if you have a generated normal map with some artifacts and you want to flatten parts of it. You just have to select the faces you want to tweak and paint over it. That's it. Okay, that's it for this example video. I invite you to experiment by yourself and to share your tricks in the comments. I've explored the tool for you and tried to outline some techniques, some use cases, but I don't do much 3D anymore. So I'm sure there are productive ways to use the tool that I haven't thought about. If you haven't seen it yet, go check out the overview of the tangent normal brush, or you can head to the second example video, which is dedicated to the UV offset mode. That said, I want to thank you all for watching. Be creative, have fun, and see you in the next video.